With the ease of digital world maps, it is possible to scroll through the entire world in a matter of seconds. However, this would not have been possible without the brilliance of Muslim cartographer Muhammad al-Idrisi. Abu Abdullah Muhammad al-Sharif al-Idrisi al-Sabt was a keen traveler from his early youth. Departing from his hometown in Morocco, he managed to travel during his teenage years to North Africa, Spain, Anatolia, and many parts of Europe. He was then hired as an advisor by King Sicily II for a span of 18 years due to his vast knowledge and travels. In the year 1154, under the recommendation of the king, al-Idrisi compiled the greatest medieval geographical book, Nuzat al-Mushtaq, the entertainment for he who longs to travel the world. Being a Muslim scholar, cartographer, and Egyptologist, al-Idrisi drew from his knowledge of the Quran in his travels, exploring over 1,200 small maps to author his book, which contained over 70 regional maps. It also contained the Tabula Rogeriana, or the Map of Roger, the first world map. In it, he depicted for the first time islands of the North Atlantic, countries of the Far East, the Indian Ocean, the Balkans, and much more. In the 12th century, his map was considered the most precise map ever made, which was then used for warfare by sultans and kings for many years to come. Up until the 15th century, his work was studied globally by geographers, as he was one of the earliest geographers to exclaim that the Earth was indeed round. This was 500 years before this realization dawned upon Galileo. Interestingly, in his map, al-Idrisi put the south at the top and the north at the bottom, which was later flipped by the Europeans in the 16th century as they wanted to be on top of the world. So technically, Australia is de facto up top and not down under. Crikey.